we are from Government Degree College for Women's from Golconda, Hyderabad. We have done a Jigyasa project on topic nanoscience by Aisha, Samrit, Vinyasa, Manasa, Nazim Javi, Preet. My topic is Introduction to Nanoscience. Nanoscience is an emerging area of science which concerns itself with the study of materials that have very small dimensions in the range of nanoscale. The word Latin nasus means drug and the word science means knowledge. Nanoscience is the study of phenomena in nanometer scale. Atoms are very small and few tenths of a nanometer in diameter and molecules particularly a few nanometers in size. Nano objects are too small to be seen with naked eyes. In fact, if one wants to see a 10 nanometer size marble in his hand, his eye would not have to be smaller than a human being. Classification of nanomaterials. Nanomaterials can be classified dimension classification with examples. One dimension less than 100 nanometer, example nanorods, nanowires. 0 or 3 dimension less than 100 nanometer, particle, examples, particles, quantum dots. This picture shows about the different nanometers on different fields. My friend states the nanoscience and physics.
Physics is the mother of natural science, and in principle, physics can be used to explain everything that goes on in nanoscale. There is active physics research going on nanomechanics, quantum computation, quantum teleportation, artificial atoms, etc. At nanometer scale, physics has different properties. Not seen on a microscopic scale. Now it's become important such as quantum computation, quantum mechanical and thermodynamic properties. Rather than working with the bulk material, one works with the individual atom and molecules by learning about the molecules, individual molecules, atoms, properties. We can put them together in a very well-defined way to produce new material and new and amazing characteristics. Some physical properties of nanomaterials, material produced at nanoscale, can suddenly show their very different properties. To compare with what they exhibit on microscopic scale and in their unique applications. This figure shows how whole became changes on nanoparticles. Now my friend Bindya will explain about this.
The first mention of nanotechnology was taken even by Richard Feynman in 1959. Feynman suggested to him to develop a engine to manipulate atoms and molecules directly. Gravity would become the least important, surface tension would become more important, Montreux attraction would become important, etc. Feynman mentioned this type of issues during his talk. Another topic is manufacturing approaches. There are mainly two major approaches. One is the bottom up and another one is the top down. Bottom up manufacturers will provide components made up of molecules which are meant to build the coherent forces. For example, uses of AFM liquid phase technique, laser measures, solder processing, and chemical vapor deposition. Top down method for manufacturing involves the construction of parts through the methods of cutting, carrying, and molding. Using this method, we have been able to fabricate a remarkable variety of machinery. For example, milling, laser abrasion, physical vapor deposition. Applications of nanotechnology is going to take their answer.
The potential applications of nanotechnology in different fields are the following: electronics and health and medicine, transportation, energy and environment, space exploration. Nanotechnology has already reached the electronics industry with futures in microprocessors now less than 100 nanometers in size. In nanotechnology, wide range of applications is there. Innovative applications, energy and medicine and drugs, nanobiotechnology, nanodevices, and optical engineering, defense and security, bioengineering, cosmetics, and nanoparticles. Some of the areas under development include improving display screens and electronic devices. This can be achieved using carbon nanotubes. They can be used as field emitters with extremely high efficiency per field emissions display. Increase the density of memory chips, reducing the size of transistors used in integrated circuits. Allowing the refrigeration with no approximately 5% of the electrical energy into light. Nanotechnological approaches like GLEDs or QCAs, quantum case atoms, to lead to a strong reduction of energy consumption in illumination. The next topic is nanotechnology and space exploration.
Nanotechnology and space exploration, most of our today rocket engines rely on chemicals. The greatest challenges in spacecraft are performance, reliability, safety, and cost. And the benefits of nanotechnology. Nanotechnology can make the structure of space lighter. Nanotechnology can improve the performance of laser cells, and there are much more benefits of nanotechnology. The conclusion will be given by Preeti.
Nanotechnology is used in computing, electronic, medicine, material, and manufacturing. We have great opportunity to make these small in size, and it is a revolution future goes by changing the current using material using durable active reactivity. Member of conference seminar and money injected into the field, we can say is rapidly expanding field.